Problem is to write a Python program to return multiple values from a function. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain, and in this video we will learn how to write a program that will allow us to return multiple values from a function. So guys, to return multiple values from a function, there is a very simple method in Python. With the two methods we can do it, like there are two solutions to do this problem. The first solution is with the help of using the tuples and packing, and the second solution is using the dictionaries. So we'll be seeing both of them one by one. Let's have a look on how it can be done. First of all, using tuples and packing is very simple. All you need to do is, first of all, because we want to return the values from a function, let's create a function here. So I'll be creating a function called as def friends. Inside this, I'm not passing any parameter, but here I'll be writing return few names, like I'll be returning Joey, comma, Phoebe, comma, Monica. Okay, once I have returned these values, I'll just print friends and let's run and see what output we'll get. So we'll be getting a tuple over here, that is Joey, Phoebe and Monica. Now what I need to do, I need to get these values separated, like not in the form of a tuple. So we will be using a tuple unpacking here. Tuple, and how does tuple unpacking work is very simple. You assign values, like there are three numbers of elements that are present inside it. So we will be creating three variables. For example, I'll be creating n1 comma n2 comma n3, which will be equal to friends. Okay, and then I will print, let's say if I print n1 and run it, it will only give me Joey. That means now what has happened, this tuple has been unpacked and has been, and these values has been distributed in three values. That means in three variables, that is n1, n2 and n3. So if I write n1 comma n2 and n3, for and I'll be using a string here. So I'll be writing AND over here inside it instead of writing it outside. Otherwise, it will treat it as an AND operator. So now let's run and see what output we'll get. So here I'll be getting the output Joey, Phoebe and Monica. If you want to give a comma over here, you can provide with a comma as well inside a string. And now if I run it, it will give me Joey, Phoebe and Monica without a tuple. Once you write the value of friends here, you'll get a tuple, and to unpack it, you need to assign it to the number of variables. The number of variables will be equal to the number of elements that are there inside the tuples. So this was our solution number one. Moving ahead and talking about our solution number two, where we will be using the dictionaries. So as our solution two says, using a dictionary, first of all, let's create a function again. So I'll be writing definition friends, that means I'll be defining a function called as friends. Over here again, I'm not going to write anything inside the parameter. I'll be writing n1, a variable called as n1. Inside n1, I'll be writing Joey, and inside n2, I'll be writing, let's say, Phoebe. Once I have written these two values, what I'll be doing, I'll be creating a dictionary. In a dictionary, what I'll be doing, I'll be writing these as the values, not as the keys, but as the values. So I'll write return a dictionary, let's say on number one is the key and the value to it is n1 comma number two is the key and the value to it is n2. So this is how a dictionary works, that we have a key and a value pair, and in dictionaries we use a curly bracket. So we have a key as 1 and the value is n1, again the key as 2 and the value is n2. Now I'll be writing names is equals to, I'll be creating a variable and putting this friends inside it. And let's print names. So if I directly write friends, for example, if I directly print friends and run it, this is the output we are going to get. But what I need to do over here is I need to assign it to a variable so that I can only obtain the values from here. So for that, I'll be writing. So if I print names, I'll get the output. Again the same, but now it names is a dictionary that has this value. Now from a dictionary, if I want to obtain only values, so here in our dictionaries we do not have a indexing for key value pairs, but we do have a indexing inside the pair. That means inside our pair, the first value is the key and the second value is the value. So here, if I talk about only this pair, if I talk about 1 and Joey, so according to our indexing, number 1 is on 0 and Joey is on number 1. Now, next thing what I need to do is I'll be writing print. Okay, now understand it in this way that if you want to receive a value of any key, you write the name of the dictionary, that is names, and then you write the name of that key. So the name of the key is 1 in our case. If suppose if it would have been, let's say, A over here, and here in this case, it would have been B. So here, what we would have written, we would have written A instead. Okay. So if I write A and run it, I will get its value. So the value of A is Joey and the value of B is Phoebe. So what I'll be doing, I'll put a comma and write the comma over here. Again, put a comma. And for obtaining Phoebe, what we'll be doing, again, we'll be writing names. And in the square bracket, we'll pass the next key. That is, the next key is B. So I'll be writing B here. And as soon as, again, I run it, I'll get the output as Joey and Phoebe. So we can put a comma or we can also write the end over here. So as soon as I run it, I'll get the output Joey and Phoebe in this way. So in this way, we can obtain multiple values from a function. So I hope guys that both the methods over here are clear to you. In our second method, what we have done is very simple. We have created a function called as friends. Inside that, we have created two variables, that is Joey and Phoebe. We have returned them in a form of a dictionary where we have created A and B as the keys and their values as N1 and N2 variables. After that, we have created a variable called as names is equals to friend to set the value of this dictionary inside the names. Once we print it, we need to call both the values. To call both the values, we will be writing the name of the dictionary, that is names. And inside the square brackets, we'll be passing the name of our keys, that is A, and the name of our another key, that is B. Hence, we will receive the output as the multiple values. So I hope guys that both the methods are clear to you and you have no doubts in the questions. The link of this code is present in our description. And for more such interesting programs, stay connected guys. Thank you.